Today, I'm going to show you through my favorite social media scheduling software. It's called Publer. No one knows about it. It seems to be one of the best kept secrets. So follow along and I'll take you through all of the things I love about it. Hey guys, Jordan here from Social Smarty. So this is Publer. And the first thing we need to do is sign up for an account. So I have already done that and I have received an email from them and then I have confirmed my email address. So once you've done all of that, you'll see a screen that looks like this. So the first thing we need to do is connect up our accounts. So I'm going to click on Add Account and I'm going to start with a Facebook page. So the first thing we need to do is give Publer access to our Facebook page. So we'll log into Facebook and we'll just follow through the steps there. So it's going to ask me to continue as myself, which makes sense, and then it pulls up all of the pages that I have access to. So I'm going to select that one there, and then next. And then it's saying, can we manage this page on your behalf? So we'll leave that all toggled on and we'll go done. And then okay, so that is our first page linked. So now we need to select it in our Publer account. So we can see a little circle there. We want to tick on that circle and then that's all done. So we've connected up our Facebook page. So now we're going to go back to accounts. We're going to add another account. This time we're going to select our Instagram account. So if we click on Instagram and then continue. And to connect up our Instagram account, we have to have a business account and it will be linked to our business page on Facebook. So that's why we're coming through Facebook. It seems a little bit different. So it's found all of the Instagram accounts that I have access to. I'm going to pick the right one, click next. It's asking me about Facebook pages. We've already connected that up, so we'll go next. Again, leave all of these toggles on and click done. And then okay, and now we head back to Publer and we just have to do that last little step once we're in there. Great, so we just click on that circle there and we have our second account connected. So part of the free plan is the ability to add up to 5 accounts. So I'm going to go ahead and add another account. This one I'm going to choose a Facebook group. So it's really handy to be able to schedule posts into your Facebook group. But the way that we connect it up is a little bit different. So what we need to do is we need to be firstly we need to be an admin on that group. And then what we need to do is give Publer access to manage that group or post in that group on our behalf. So that's what I'm doing now. Cool, so we can see that Publer has found one group that I'm an admin on. Now see how it has that exclamation mark there? That's telling me that we haven't actually installed the app or given the app permission to manage that group. So we just click on that there and that's going to take us back into Facebook. It's going to take us into our group and it's going to take us into the settings where we add Publer. So see, these are all of the apps we can install on our group. Let's get rid of that. So I'm going to type in Publer. Great, there it is there. So we want to install the Publer app into our Facebook group. So we'll do that. Cool, so that's done now. Now it's really frustrating how it doesn't automatically take you back into Publer. So we're going to have to go back to Publer the manual way. So we'll head back in there. So I just went to Publer.io to get back into the Publer dashboard. And now we're going to go back to adding accounts because we've just got one last little step to add that group. So I'm going to click on group there. And so now that we've added that app into the group, we can now connect it up with our Publer account. A little bit confusing, but just follow the steps I've taken you through here and you won't have any trouble. Cool, so the last step is to click on that circle there and that has connected up our Facebook group. So now we can go back to accounts. We can have a look through, are there other accounts we want to add? Maybe our Google My Business listing, YouTube, maybe LinkedIn. So for this one, I'm going to add my LinkedIn account. And you can choose whether you add your profile or your page. So I'm going to add both. I'm going to start with my profile. It's going to ask me to log in. And again, we're just giving Publer permission to post to LinkedIn on our behalf. So there's my profile there, I'll click on the circle and that's done. I'll go back and my last account with my 5 free accounts is going to be my LinkedIn company page. So because I've already given Publer access to my LinkedIn account, it's pulled up all of the company pages that I am an administrator on. And so I'm going to look for the right one, which is that one there, and I'm going to connect that up. So make sure you connect the right one if you've got a few different accounts. So now I have my five accounts, which are all connected up to Publer. I can start creating content. So I'm going to head to the Create button here. I'm going to click on Create. Now there's a couple of different ways that you can create content. And the first thing I ask myself is, when I'm creating a new post, am I likely to reuse this post? So if you create something that maybe you post, you know, every 3 months, or something that I would call evergreen content, I would do it slightly different than if it was just a timely post that isn't going to make sense in, you know, a week or a month's time. So the first thing we would do if we're going to create an evergreen post or something we can reuse is I would click on my click or drag or drop media. And then we have lots of different ways that we can import the media for this post. So we obviously have, you know, our Google Drive we can connect up, our Dropbox, our OneDrive. We can get images directly from Unsplash. So Unsplash is a stock images site. We can save images into our library. We can even design them in Canva or Crello, so directly in the app itself. So if you want to create your design in Canva, there's a couple of different ways you can do it. So you could click on Canva here, it's going to open up the Canva editing tool, and you can create the design right then and there inside Publer. The other way that to do it, and this is the way I do it, is I just go into my Canva account like I normally would, and create the design. So this one here is actually a template that's available inside my training hub. So once I'm happy with it, I would click on the three dots here, and instead of downloading, I would share. So I would click see all, and then we're going to scroll down until we see Publer. So what we're going to do is share our design directly from Canva into our Publer account. So I would click Publer, and then it's going to ask me which team, which I'm, you know, I'm working on my own inside Publer, so it'll just be that one there. It's going to ask me what file type, if I wanted all pages. So for this one, I might just say one page, and then save. And so that is going to push the design from my Canva account into my Publer library. So if I come back into Publer, and if I click on my library here, you'll see within the library we have this Canva tab. So if I click on Canva, I'm going to see that design is sitting there waiting for me to use. And it's just as simple as clicking on the tick box there. So I'm going to click Use Media. Cool. And so then I'm going to pop in all of my text. So whatever my caption is, I'm going to type that in here. You can edit your text. So see how we've got bold, italics, things like that. We can add in emojis, all that sort of thing. It also does give you hashtag suggestions, although I find that they're not very good. So I do my own hashtag research and use my own hashtags, but you can come through and see what's trending and use those if you like. So once this is all ready to go, this is a post that I'm likely to use, you know, more than once, I would then save it as a draft. So I would click on draft, and then it will sit in my sort of draft library, which means that I can use it over and over again. So then if I was to use that draft, I would go into posts, I would toggle down to drafts, I would find that post, and I would click on use. And when I click use, it's going to say, do you want to delete it once you've used it? And I'll say no, because I want to reuse this. So I'll say don't delete. So that's going to have, you know, it's going to stay there in my drafts. The next thing I need to do is pick my channels. So if I want it to go to my Facebook group, my Facebook page, my Instagram, my LinkedIn personal profile, and my LinkedIn company page, I can click all five. And we can see here which channels we've selected. So once the post is all done, we're happy with it. Really important to click on this little signpost icon here. So we click on that, and what that does is it splits out the post into the different channels. So for Facebook, for example, we might put in, you know, a link to our website, whatever that is. Instagram, we know that links don't work, so instead we would say click on the link in my bio. And also add in our hashtag. So hashtags are really important for Instagram. We want to aim for 30 hashtags in there. LinkedIn, again, we might put in a link because links work there. And we want to use 5 hashtags for LinkedIn. And so once we're happy with that and we've tweaked each of those different channels, then we will click preview. So we want to see what this is going to look like before it publishes. And we can toggle through. So we have our Facebook group. This is what it's going to look like. We can switch between a mobile view and a desktop view. We can come to our Facebook page, our Instagram account, LinkedIn personal profile, and our LinkedIn company page, and just get a really good understanding of what it's going to look like. Are we happy with that layout? Once we're happy with that, we click close, and then we come down to schedule. So there's a couple of different options. So if we click on schedule, it's going to say, great, when do you want this to go out? So we'd pick a date and a time, and then magically on that day at that time, the posts are going to pop out to all 5 of those channels we've selected. But we do have some other options in here. So auto schedule is where we set up a schedule. So we might say we want to post 3 times a week at 9 a.m. on Monday, Wednesday and Friday, for example. If we click on auto schedule, Publer will just find the next available slot and slot that in. Recycle means that we want to use that post again, and so that's another way of creating that draft post that we can use again. Recurring is when you set up a post to go out, say, every week. Now, recurring is a paid feature, so you get a short trial of the recurring feature, but you would need to use a paid plan if you want to use that on an ongoing basis. So once that's all done, and we'll schedule it, so let's just say schedule that for next week. Let's say 8 a.m. schedule, and so that's going to disappear. And then what we can do is come into our calendar. So our calendar gives us a few different views. So we can see for next week that we have all of those posts scheduled out. And so we've got a week view, we've got a month view, so we can see the whole month what we have scheduled going out here. And the other thing we can do is when we select our Instagram account, we can do a feed view. So this gives us what that's going to look like when it pops out into our feed or into our grid. So if you're creating a kind of aesthetic for your Instagram grid, you might want to come over and just have a look and see if it's going to fit with the theme that you're going for. So let's just go back to all 5 accounts. So you can obviously filter through to the accounts. We've got our weekly feed. We can see our posts here. Now, if I saw that and I thought, actually, I want to move this one for my Facebook group, I want to actually move that to Friday. It's just as easy as that. So we can just drag and drop, move these posts around so that they're going out on different days. So it's pretty easy to use. The other things you can do, so if we come into the media library, so we can upload a whole lot of media at once, then we can schedule it out, or you can upload the media as your creating the posts. If you need to change accounts, you would obviously come in here. You can delete accounts, re-add them, add new accounts. The content, I believe, is a paid feature. Yeah, so this would give you some ideas for content that you can share, but I'm using a free plan here. And yeah, it's really, really simple to use. It can save you a whole lot of time, particularly if you create those draft posts for things that you're going to reuse. It is a really good system. So check out the link in the description. It is an affiliate link, so if you click on it, I might get a few cents. Yeah, let me know if you have any questions.